Pikachu and friends in Storytime Adventures.
Choo-Choo and her friends were in school. Suddenly, Cha-Cha ran up to them. He looked very afraid.
Huh? What's wrong, Cha-Cha? Is something troubling you? Choo-Choo, there's a big boy bullying all the little kids. He's taking all of our pencils.
Don't worry, Cha-Cha. We'll stop him.
We can't. He's too big and too strong.
We may be small, Cha-Cha, but we're strong if we all stick together. Come on, let me tell you a story about strength and unity, and how the little creatures of the forest banded together and saved themselves from a big, mean elephant. Long, long ago, there was a beautiful forest. The little animals who lived there were very happy. The sparrows sang songs in their nests. The bees buzzed cheerfully. The frogs hopped around without a care. The rabbits scampered around having fun. And the woodpeckers kept themselves busy looking for worms in the trees. One day, an elephant moved into the forest. The little animals thought the elephant would be kind and friendly. But to their disappointment, the elephant turned out to be very mean. The elephant did some very nasty things. He broke the branches the sparrows had built their nests in.
Yikes!
He trampled on the rabbits and the frogs. He destroyed the beehives. The elephant even pulled out the tree the woodpecker was pecking at. And he shook it as if it were a baby's rattle.
Oi!
All the birds and animals were worried about the elephant.
We must do something about that elephant. He's ruining our lives.
We must get him to leave us alone.
Oh.
So, the animal sent the woodpecker to talk to the elephant.
Mr. Elephant, my friends have sent me here. I have a message for you. We'd like for you to leave us alone.
The elephant laughed at the woodpecker.
Why should I listen to you? I'm a huge and mighty animal, and you are all weak little creatures. Go away and tell your friends I'll do whatever I want.
And so the elephant continued tormenting the little animals. All the little animals went to visit the owl that night. He was a wise old bird who lived on one of the trees.
Mr. Owl, can you help us? The elephant is tormenting us because we are weak and small.
You are wrong, my friends. You may be small, but you are definitely not weak. You all are very strong, and you will be stronger if you all work together. Listen carefully now. I have a plan.
And so the wise old owl told the little animals about his plan. The next day, the elephant woke up and got ready to trouble the little animals.
I will have fun troubling the little animals again today.
To annoy the elephant.
Ugh! The bees are very noisy today. I must shut my eyes and flap my ears.
The moment the elephant shut his eyes, the woodpecker flew down and pecked them.
Ow! Ow! My eyes! Something's pricking them. I better wash them in the pond.
And so the elephant ran with his eyes shut. Standing near a ditch, the frogs began croaking. The elephant heard them, and he ran towards the ditch, thinking it was the pond.
I can hear the frogs croaking. The pond must be right ahead.
The elephant fell right into the ditch.
Yo!
The ditch was very deep, and the elephant realized that he couldn't get out of it on his own.
Help! Can somebody help me out of this ditch?
The owl and the little animals then gathered around the ditch.
My friends can help you, Mr. Elephant. But if you want them to help you, you must promise to be kind and to never trouble them again.
I promise I'll be kind. I'll never trouble them ever again.
The little animals then helped the elephant. They called the little forest rangers. And the little forest rangers came to help the elephant.
Don't worry. We'll have you out in a few minutes.
The elephant was very grateful for the little animal's help.
Thank you, everyone. You have been very kind. I'm sorry I troubled you. I thought you were small and weak, but you are all very strong.
We are strong because we stick together.
You should join us and be our friend. We'll all be stronger and happier that way.
And so the elephant and the little animals became friends. The elephant also realized that he felt nicer when he was kind. And so, he never troubled anyone again.
Just as Choo-Choo finished telling Cha-Cha the story, the boy who had been troubling Cha-Cha came by.
Cha-Cha, give me your pencils.
Huh?
Choo-Choo and the others came forward and stood with Cha-Cha.
Hi, we are Cha-Cha's friends.
Do you want pencils? We can give you ours. I'll give you my pencils too, but you must ask nicely.
Huh? I'm sorry.
The boy stopped troubling Cha-Cha. He realized that Cha-Cha wasn't small and weak when he was with his friends. He also became kinder and nicer, which made everyone like him.